to contain, de facto, epidemic, lockdown, multiple organ failure, outbreak, pandemic, to predate, quarantine, self-isolation, septic shock, strain, taxonomy, virologist, zoonotic. More than 265,071 people have been infected with the novel virus, with significant outbreaks in Italy, Iran, and Spain, and 177 deaths in the UK. On December 31, 2019, the World Health Organization's China office heard the first reports of a previously unknown virus behind a number of pneumonia cases in Wuhan, a city in eastern China with a population of over 11 million. What started as an epidemic, mainly limited to China, has now become a truly global pandemic. There have now been over 265,495 confirmed cases and 9,785 deaths, according to the Johns Hopkins University COVID-19 dashboard, which collates information from national and international health authorities. The disease has been detected in more than 150 countries and territories, with Italy, Iran, and Spain experiencing the most widespread outbreaks outside of China. In the UK, there have been 3,983 confirmed cases and 177 deaths as of March 20. The Chinese government responded to the initial outbreak by placing Wuhan and nearby cities under a de facto quarantine, encompassing roughly 50 million people in Hubei province. This quarantine is now slowly being lifted as authorities watch to see whether cases will rise again. In Italy, which is experiencing the largest outbreak outside of China, the government took the unprecedented step of extending a lockdown to the entire country, shutting cinemas, theatres, gyms, discos and pubs, and banning funerals and weddings. In the UK, the government has shut pubs, restaurants, bars and cafes, advised people to avoid all unnecessary social interaction or travel, and directed households in which one person falls ill with coronavirus symptoms to quarantine themselves for 14 days. On March 11, the WHO officially declared that the COVID-19 outbreak is a pandemic. WHO has been assessing this outbreak around the clock, and we are deeply concerned both by the alarming levels of spread and severity and by the alarming levels of inaction, said its Director General Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus. Although the WHO designated COVID-19 a public health emergency of international concern, or PHEIC, on January the 30th, it has been reluctant to call it a pandemic. Pandemic is not a word to use lightly or carelessly. It is a word that, if misused, can cause unreasonable fear or unjustified acceptance that the fight is over, leading to unnecessary suffering and death, Adarnam said. A quick note on naming. Although popularly referred to as coronavirus, on February the 11th, the WHO announced the official name of the disease, COVID-19. The virus that causes that disease is likely to be called Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2, or SARS-CoV-2 for short, according to a draft paper from the International Committee on the Taxonomy of Viruses.